and I'm back with Mr. Tinashe Jonasi. How are you, sir?
I'm as fit as a fiddle.
You are a very powerful politician, but you've been quiet for the past month. What was happening?
Yeah, no, you know, some people, they went on holiday in December. Sometimes as a party, you are not only there to address the public. Sometimes you are there to do the internal politics, strategies and stuff. Yeah, so we're busy in intra-party strategies and activities.
But all the groups that are coming up trying to do armed uprising, yourself,
yeah,
Mr. Matapu,
mm-hmm.
There's been fighting in the groups.
Mm-hmm.
What is happening? Why do your groups end up fighting?
Thank you. Mr. Matapo's movement, my movement, we are small movements. I can say 90% of Zimbabweans or more, they are under the MDC project. That means your young people who can even train militarily. That means you, even your donors, any Zimbabwean who has got money, sponsors MDC. When you are Tinashe, a sponsor would call me and say, Tinashe, you want sponsorship? Yes. If you want sponsorship, work with Nelson Chamisa. A revolution is not done one day.
Okay, but are you going to go to Zimbabwe?
Myself.
Because you can't do a battle from South Africa.
No. We are going to go to Zimbabwe. But remember, this project is highly complex. It's highly complicated. Meaning, whatever we do as a movement, I do Zimbabwe, must include international powers. Because the AU and SADC, they are supporting ZANU-PF. So this project must be including international partnerships. Otherwise, those partners are the ones who can silence SADC and AU. Without international superpowers, we will be lying. So we are in Africa. South Africa supports ZANU-PF. SADC Africa supports ZANU-PF because they are all dictators. So this project is engagement of international partners.
Okay, so in short, you are still in the strategizing phase.
Yes, we had some target the African countries,
yeah,
that we wanted to work with.
Okay.
But obviously they are scared because the whole Africa would be against them. So now it's strictly international partnerships. Everyone we work with, they approached. We make people rich in our party. Anyone known that is around Tinashe is given money to do anything. To because they know that if people are not funding Tinashe will do nothing.
Okay.
Yeah.
So people were paid.
Yes.
To smear campaign you.
100%.
Have you put safeguards around yourself to avoid this situation?
Yeah, you know, you always do, but obviously this is the mighty power of the state of Zimbabwe. That's why I'm saying we are very much vigorously engaging our international partners. Because if we are to hit Zimbabwe, obviously we should hit Zimbabwe from overseas, not from Africa.
Okay.
So we are relocating the whole project overseas.
Okay.
Because in Africa, South Africa on its own, they are against us. So that's the delay of the project. We thought we can do it from Africa. We had some promised alliances, some countries in Africa, but they chickened out because they were threatened by the African Union and SADC. So any operation must be run from overseas.
To me, it's almost becoming like we're in a dark tunnel.
Yeah.
And there's no light at the end of the tunnel.
Dark tunnel of Zimbabweans, number one, they need deliverance. I think the majority of us, we are worshipping the devil. Because the real God is a good shepherd. Faith moves mountains. A true Christian is fearless. But Zimbabweans can wet their pants when you talk about ZANU-PF, when you talk about CIOs. We must be worshipping a devil, not a true God.
Is it cowardice? Is it education? What is it?
Yeah, stupid education. Stupid education. We do risk analysis. People like Tinashe, people can think I'm a ZANU-PF project because I'm brave. A Zimbabwean think that to have a Zimbabwean ID, you must be fearful. We are, as I said, we are a nation of foolish citizens.
Right. Thank you very much, Mr. Tinashe Jonasi. We'll be back again very, very soon. Is there anything else you want to say before we close?
Zimbabweans, seek deliverance. Zimbabweans, wake up. It's your choice to delay our freedom with 1 day, with 2 years, with 10 years. The freedom of Zimbabwe is in your hands. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.